Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to Vidyasagar Classes Educational YouTube channel. As a series of videos on idioms and phrases, today we have come up with few idioms which will be highly beneficial for you for your competitive exam. So let us start from today's idiom. Today's first idiom is far cry from. That means which you have expected, but by the time you see the result, it is beyond your expectation. It is beyond your expectation. Beyond your expectations. A thing that is very different from something else. What you did was a far cry from what you said you are going to do. That means suppose you are thinking that if you go to a village, you will get best of the facilities. But by the time you reach there, you see things are not what you have imagined. So that is far cry from. Then feel a bit under the weather. That means when you are sick, you are unwell, you are physically unwell. That means you are physically not feeling well, physically on well, feeling sick or unhealthy. I'm not coming to the office today. I'm feeling a bit under the weather. Give the benefit of the doubt. Believe someone's statement without proof. I knew him since the past 5 years, so I gave him the benefit of the doubt. For example, you must have seen in cricket matches, when the umpire is undecided whether the batsman is run out or not, more often than not, the batsman gets the benefit of the doubt because there is no clear-cut proof. There is no clear-cut proof. When there is no proof, you can say he is getting the benefit of the doubt. Then hear through the grapevine. That means to hear the news from someone who heard the news from someone else. That means that is not authentic. I heard through the grapevine that she is pregnant. Not from directly. Not hear that means not hear directly from the actual source. Okay. Not here directly. Indirectly, when you hear any news, that means hear through the grapevine. Hit the nail on the head. This is one of the most popular idioms used in any argument. To do or say exactly the right thing. You have spotted the flaw, Robert. You have hit the nail on the head. Suppose you are answering a question asked by your teacher and you answer the exact thing that your teacher is looking for, that means absolute correct answer. That means absolutely correct answer. That means hit the nail on the head. Then hit the sack, seats and hay. That means retiring to bed, to go to bed. When you are completely exhausted and you hit the sack, seat and hay, that means you are about to sleep. About to sleep. To go to bed or about to sleep. I am exhausted. I think I just hit the sack or seat or the hay. In the heat of the moment, that means in a state of anger, more often than not we make mistake or we regret something when you say something in the heat of the moment. That means in a state of anger, in a state of anger, overwhelmed by what is happening at the moment. He doesn't hate you, he just said in the heat of the moment. So, if we should not mind someone's harsh word or rude words, if it is said in the heat of the moment. It takes two to tango. Both people involved in a bad situation are responsible for it. That means you cannot simply blame someone. Gotte hatare tali bajeni. It takes two to tango. That means two are responsible. That means two people are responsible for any untoward incident. He blamed her for the lack of attention. Well, it takes two to the tango. Simply suppose there is a misunderstanding between a husband and wife. Yes, maybe there is more fault on the part of husband, but it takes two to tango. Jump the bandwagon. That means join a popular trend or activity which is done by everyone. Nowadays, vaccination is going. You don't know whether it is good or bad. You simply jump the bandwagon and get vaccinated. That means it is a popular trend. It's a popular trend. Join the popular trend or go by the recent trend. Okay, so many people are playing that game that I might as well jump on the bandwagon. But what everybody does, we do the same, that is jumping on the bandwagon. Keep something at bay. That means keep something away. A good way to keep your anxiety at bay is through motivation. That means keep the bad thing under check. That means keep something. Keep something at check. Or check something. For example, I will give you a cricketing example. Suppose there is a very good bowling pitch, and a cricketer called Cheteshwar Pujara. He kept the Australian bowlers at bay during that famous Brisbane test win. That means he keep their good balls away. A good way to keep your anxiety at bay is through meditation. That is the example we have given. So, these are the few idioms which we have discussed. I hope you have liked this video. Please subscribe our channel for more such informative video. Thank you for watching. Goodbye till our next video.